Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield.
Really good job by the big guys up front to use their size and speed and get the runner in the backfield.
From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. Scrambling around. And he's taken down around the 36-yard line. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look. Nice catch, first down, and he's knocked out.
I'll tell you something, I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
From their own 49-yard line, first down. He's at the 40, he's at the 30. And they make the stop at about the 23-yard line.
That always stings the defense to give up a big running play like that. They don't want to give up big chunks of yards on the ground.
So it's second and 12. Ball on the 25-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. Runs with it, and he's got room. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. And goal from the five, and looking to cap this off with a touchdown. He's on the run, keeps it, and he's got a touchdown. Really a nice run there by that quarterback.
Well, great decision by the quarterback reading the defense, and as soon as he saw the open field, he cut it upfield and scored the touchdown.
And he hits the PAT. A seven-play, 69-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. And they can forget about returning this one. The Knights have shown over the course of the season that they want to get this guy the football, but you can't just go to him every play.
Well, on the road, you especially want to take the crowd out of the game, and the one guy you know who can do it is this wide receiver. The problem you have is this defense, more often than not, is going to be aligned to take him out of the game. And that, to your point, Brad, that's where somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game, some of the other receivers. You're going to have to take some of the pressure off of him and really make it a team effort to be able to win this game on the road.
And he busted that one wide open.
On defense, you can't afford to give up big runs like that.
So it's first and 10 after the big run. Tackle to 37-yard line. That brings up second and 9. his receiver who's all alone. And he tackles him hard at the 25-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
From the 25-yard line, it's first down. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Inside the 10, and it pays off. Touchdown.
He is such a talented, skillful back, as you saw right there. What makes him even better is that these coaches know how to use him.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he adds the extra point. A nice five-play, 76-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
He's out to the 30. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. Decent run up the gut.
That makes it second and six.
It's second down, six to go. Ball on their own 37. Feeds it to the back. Loss of one there for the halfback.
Loss of 1 yard on the play.
Taken down at about the 41. So the defense does their job well on that series. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Room around the corner. And down he goes at the 31-yard line. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over.
Pickup.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. They try to get a head start there.
False start. Offense.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost them 5 yards.
Still second down.
First down, and he's knocked out of bounds.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 45-yard line, first down. Tackled around the 30-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 30. And he is drilled at the 27. 3-yard gain by the running back.
They're lucky he was able to hang on to the football. He took a pretty good shot.
So at the end of one, we're even at 7 in this one.
ready for more football here in quarter number two.
Inside the 10. He's all the way. Touchdown. He makes the PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Made
at about the 27-yard line.
It's second down, eight to go. Ball on the 27. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He's pushed out of bounds at the 32. They get 5 yards on the play.
You don't have to go deep every play to be successful. They got 5 yards on the play, and that's always a good game. Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
So no luck on that drive as they go three and out. He really got a hold of that one. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 37.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
Brought down at the 40-yard line.
That makes it second and eight.
Second and eight. Ball on the 40-yard line. Just throws this one away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers.
Quick out to his receiver. He's tackled at midfield.
We've got a change at the quarterback position. You've got to wonder how that's going to affect this offense. I would think the offensive coordinator and the head coach are just going to try to ease him into this game at the beginning.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 50-yard line. And he's knocked down immediately after the catch.
That makes it first and 10.
Complete. He's got room to work. They'll bring him down at the 16.
Number 25 makes the tackle at the 16.
From the 16-yard line. First down. Nice play to set up first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
They go with a toss, and down he goes at the 9.
That brings up second goal.
the 9-yard line. It's second down. He's scrambling. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown.
What made this so impressive was, first, his ability to see where the space was to run, and then the athletic ability to get it into the end zone.
And he tacks on the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The last time this offense had the ball, it was 3 and out. He makes it to the 28-yard line. The Bulldogs taking their first time out of the half. About 2 minutes before halftime.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
Nice play fake. He's to the 40. And he's taken down at about the 37-yard line.
So you've got a guy who's not only liable to beat you with his arm, but with his legs, too. That is a tough quarterback to stop.
First down and 10 to go after the big gain on the run. It's a 2-yard loss.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
And he can't get away from the pressure.
That makes it 3rd and 15.
They'll line it up again on third down. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Throws it. Watch out. Oh, almost had a pick.
This unit has quick hands, and they showed it there by knocking away the pass.
And they're coming after this punter. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. The Knights offensive staff, I think, has done a good job of keeping their wide receiver in the game. Even though he's not having great stats, he's part of it, and the rest of the team now is picking up his slack, I think.
Well, this offense is still putting points on the board, and I think at times they're actually using the wide receiver, the go-to man who's drawing so much attention, really as a decoy to open up other avenues of this offense. We've seen other receivers make some plays. They're running the football. So it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments this defense makes to try to slow down these other members of this offense. And who knows, maybe that could open it back up for that marquee receiver.
He's under pressure. Receivers got the first down. The Knights call a timeout. That's their second of the half. From their own 43-yard line, it's first down. They come out in a 5-wide set. Fires it out. He goes out of bounds at about the 39-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Right, Great catch there before they can knock him out of bounds.
That makes it first and goal.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. And they make the stop at the 9-yard line. Quickly to the tight end. He's got it. Touchdown. The tight end scored that time and with authority.
Brady's a physical football player, but he's also got the finesse to make a big impact in the passing game.
Converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being.
At about the 33-yard line. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Good tackle there in space. The pass is complete for 7 yards, and that'll be a first down.
And how about the poise of this quarterback to locate his receiver past the sticks and get him the ball? That was a great throw.
Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Slides down to the ground.
Well, this is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback.
Scrambling around. He's taken down at about the 19-yard line.
The offense coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's the third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
And the field goal is good. So we've played two quarters. The Knights lead it 28-10.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
It's all about perspective. Everybody who loves offense loved that first half. Lots of big plays, explosive plays. Offense has really got into the rhythm. But then there's the responsible opposing view finding all the things that went wrong on the defensive side.
Yeah, it's twofold. You know, there's an offense and there's a defense. And at some point,
I'm glad you've noticed that.
Yeah, well, I didn't notice it in the first half, but
I'd
like to notice more of it in the second half. And it's as simple. When a wide receiver catches a slant at 7 yards and takes it 70, there's a problem. Somebody needs to hit the guy. Somebody needs to be a little bit physical. Somebody needs to be willing to tackle the guy and bring him to the ground. Too many missed tackles, too many explosive plays. And if you play defense like that, you should probably look in behind you and say, I think I'm going to get the other guy in because he's got to be better than this guy to start.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He really got a hold of that kick. And they can forget about returning this one.
Boy, this offense has been consistent throughout this entire football game. The quarterback's doing a good job of leading this team. How about the offensive line, the job that they've done? Just a great team effort to allow this offense to have a spectacular performance.
And here we go.
go with the offense ready to get things going again. Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. Nice run there. A nice option play. The tailback gets 6 yards before he's brought down. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. And he's tackled in the open field. He didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Inside the 30. Huge gain, and that sets him up nicely with a first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. He makes it out to maybe the 10-yard line. So he gets maybe a yard on the option. They'll be looking for the end zone here. Third and goal from the 9. And he's tackled at the 5-yard line.
Gaining 4 yards. That brings up fourth and goal.
He gets it up, and it splits the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. Second and 15. Ball on their own 20. Backward pass. That's a fumble. It's scooped up. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. Quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation. And a quick throw. And that was a really well-played series by the defense. They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. And this one is a beauty. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. A scoring drive, the last time out for this offense, and they'll huddle up for this drive. Tackle made around the 30-yard line. From their own 30-yard line. Second down. Throws complete, and he stopped immediately.
That's good work, man. it's third and seven.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. Here comes the offense, hoping to erase the memory of the fumble on their last drive.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Nothing doing that time. Defender stayed home, blocking wasn't there, and down he went.
From their own 19-yard line, second down. He's tackled around the 33-yard line. Player down. I'm not sure what happened. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Runs outside for a nice gain. That's three down and one to go. The Knights with a 3-touchdown advantage. We're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. And they'll lose a yard there.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
From their own 45-yard line, it's second down. Dumps it complete, the tight end over the middle. They'll bring him down right around the 48-yard line.
That'll bring up third and four.
Gets to about the 47-yard line. They'll be short of the first down after that unsuccessful running play.
Nice job here by the defense of holding firm and forcing a fourth down.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. And he tackles him hard at the 35. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. It to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. He's brought down in the open field. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 23-yard line. He's scrambling. There's a fumble. He picks it up, and down he goes at the 24-yard line. From the 24-yard line,
Second down. Now he tries to buy some time. That makes four sacks today.
Well, this speed is difficult to defend because you have to try to keep them off balance so they can't use their quickness.
We're at the 12th play of the drive. He's looking for six.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Well, they're looking for another fourth down conversion. They've already gotten one this drive. The cavalry's coming. Going for it all to the end zone. Tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable in one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
So they go to the air on fourth down when they needed a big play, and boy, do they come through. He makes the PAT. It out to maybe the 39-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Just under three to go in regulation. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. He gets hit out of bounds at the 12-yard line. From the 12-yard line, first down. To his tight end, nothing doing.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver, maybe every other member of this offense. But the wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play.
Lateral's back, scoops up the loose ball, and he hits him hard at the 3-yard line. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? And they get the safety.
Maybe he forgot where he was on the field, but he needed to unload that ball a lot sooner.
He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. A fumble really hurt this team's last drive, so let's see if they can make up for that blunder on this drive.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
Tackled after a decent pickup. The Bulldogs are going to call their second timeout. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Tackle around the 45-yard line. And that was an excellent run there.
Yeah, Brad, but it was also great blocking up front by the offensive line to open up the hole.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Gain of 5 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 6.
Second down and 6. Ball on the 40. He's taken down around the 32-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. First down.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team. The Knights coaching staff, Kirk, do they start wondering, hey, are we going to have trouble with our star player after the struggles he had today?
Well, I think the coaching staff's got to be happy that this team was able to win the football game and overcome the fact that their star player didn't have a great game. But I think making adjustments and changing the game plan because their star didn't deliver, I think that would be a big mistake.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.